If you are under level 100 and you have purchased even a single DLC operator, whether it be with Renown or R6 credits, you're doing things completely wrong. That may sound counterintuitive, but I'm going to explain why that's the case later in the video. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Quackleton. I'm a 1x Rainbow Six Siege Diamond, 3x Platinum, and prior to that, I was a Hardstuck Gold for multiple years. I've played the game since Blood Orchid. I'm a level 295. Seeing as I had to work my way up from Gold all the way to Diamond, I thought who better of a person than to give you guys this advice as opposed to all these other streamers and YouTubers that have been Diamond since they got the game and they can't properly relate to people in situations like you. So here are my top 5 tips for new Siege players or people looking to improve at the game overall. Let me get off topic real quick. There's actually a bonus tip at the end of this video, so stay tuned for that because you guys are not going to want to miss this one. This is the most important tip you will need to go from Silver or lower to Diamond or higher. My first tip, this one mostly applies to new players, but this can be used for anybody just looking to improve. Play as aggressive as possible early on. Essentially what you're trying to do is learn the maps, get into as many gunfights and situations as you can to find out what works and what doesn't. And you're going to fail a lot at this early on, but this is a good thing because learning from your mistakes is essential to improving at the game. If you avoid situations where you're worried you're going to make a mistake, you're never going to improve at the game. You're going to stay at a steady, average to below average, possibly slightly above average rate, but you're never going to get better, and that's going to hurt your capability as a player in the long run, especially once you get to those higher levels and start pushing for those higher ranks like upper platinum, diamond, and even champion. Tip number 2 is have more than one 5-stack. Now, a lot of people will tell you have one 5-stack in general, at least, but the case is, if you only have one 5-stack, there are going to be situations where not all 5 are on, you're stuck playing with the same people consistently, and you eventually get into a standstill where you're always in the same situations. You're not learning because your teammates will have their set playstyles that you bounce off of, and you're not putting yourself in situations that you have to be able to play in order to be a good player. And this is why you need to have multiple 5-stacks of teammates that are both better than you, the same skill as you, and worse than you, and play with all of them consistently. This will condition you to work better with different types of players in different situations, playing off of teammates with different playstyles, and overall make you a better player in the long run. Tip number 3 is do not choose a main until you've mastered every operator in the game. There are very few operators in this game that are one size fits all and work in every single situation. And on top of that, you have to account for operator nerfs, operator buffs, and rebalancing. For example, I was an Ashe main for a long time. Ashe went from my least played operator to my most played operator over the span of one season. One thing I learned is that there's a lot of situations where Ashe could be useful. You run into site and kill everybody. There's always going to be those situations where the operator that you currently main or refuse to play somebody else, you're going to get in situations where that operator can't help the team. For example, as an Ashe main, you run into site, 5 goo mines, 5 Capkin traps, 2 mirror windows, and a cracked Jaeger on Adderall that's been playing the game all morning, who for some reason drop shots every single shot. This is why you want to get accustomed to every single operator before you decide on which one you want to overall main, and even then, you don't want to main that operator in particular because it's going to be a lot of situations, especially if you're playing with a coordinated team that's doing strats and you need to play a specific operator to fill your role on the team. You can't just play Ashe every round and rush into site, and you can't play Pulse every round when there's a 200 IQ on the enemy team that can see your Pulse and snipe you through 2 floors, 2 windows, and a reinforced hatch from across the map. In a lot of situations, certain operators that you might main and have all your skill in that specific operator, you're not going to be able to play them. And that doesn't even take into account operator bans, which, if you're a Thatcher main, a Mirror main, that's basically out of the picture. A lot of times, like it or not, you're eventually going to run into enemies that are able to outfrag you, and you're just wasted potential when you could have been playing someone like Twitch, someone like Thatcher, someone like Thermite. Team comp is far more important than capability of winning gunfights. That's still important, but you need to be overall good at playing operators that can best support your team. Okay, So my fourth tip, and hear me out, this is going to sound really counterintuitive seeing as you're watching this video right now, but don't waste your time watching these Twitch streamers, these YouTubers. While watching videos like these ones can help your gameplay and help complement it, the only real way to improve at the game is to actually play the game, find yourself in as many situations as you can, fail, make mistakes, learn from your mistakes, and improve. If you sit watching Siege videos all day, every day, and you only play the game one match a day, you're not gonna get better because these YouTube videos, like I said, they're made to complement your gameplay but not replace it. Gameplay is the best way to improve at the game. And this brings me to my final tip, which I hinted at early in the intro. This one is going to indirectly make you a better player at Siege, despite not being directly related to in-game aspects like ranking up, elo, getting kills, playing your role on a team. This tip is crucial. And if you don't follow it, you will regret it 100% guaranteed in the future. And that tip is, before you buy any operators, besides maybe the default ones because they cost like 1,000 renown or less, before you buy any DLC operators, buy the current seasonal camos, all of them. Whether that be with renown or R6 credits, it doesn't matter. But if you don't buy these, you will 100% regret it in the future, and it'll damage your overall satisfaction that you get out of the game, thus making you a worse player in the long run. And I can say this from experience, as somebody who started the game in Blood Orchid, I didn't buy a single camo that was out at the time. I was too busy spending my renown and R6 credits on operators, and now look at all these camos that I can never get. Immediately prior to this, I decided, over the course of year 3, I decided I would buy maybe one or two seasonals per season. Excluding the season Alibi and Maestro came out, I didn't buy a single camo then, and I regret it. I was lucky enough to go back and get all the Chinese New Year camos that were recently re-added to the game for a limited time. However, the one thing I do not regret is starting, I believe, Wind Bastion, potentially the season after that, I purchased every single Universal seasonal skin in the game that has come out since then. And that brings me into our bonus tip, which is make a friend who is Diamond and have them play on your account for you and get you Diamond. That's what I did. Prior to that, I was a Platinum. However, by far the easiest way to get Diamond is just to meet a friend that's Diamond, pay them, or just ask them nicely to play on your account. And there you go, you get Diamond. As you can see here, I have the Diamond Charm. I did absolutely nothing to get this besides sit on my ass and let my friend play on my account for a whole season. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good luck in getting Diamond. I wish you all the best. Echo 10 out. Baby bet, hey, cover X, hey, cover panties on your